time. Hello?
Jamie? Jamie?
Aaron? You there?
Hello?
Can you hear me?
What is happening? What?
You're not safe, Aaron.
How are...
You have to listen to me. Do exactly as I say.
Jamie, what is going on? Where are you? I don't...
Just listen. Listen. There's a cupboard in there. You have to get inside right now.
What are you talking about?
Just hide, Aaron.
Why are you telling me this? What's happening?
Aaron, now. Just trust me, okay?
Charlie?
Jamie? Hello?
Where the hell are they?
Hopefully somewhere safe, wondering where the hell we are.
Kate, check this out.
What is going on? are we locked in here?
Looks like it, yeah.
Wait. Shh.
What?
Shh. You hear that?
Is that them?
Where's it coming from?
Somebody's in the restaurant.
What's the plan, Charlie? You end up dead. I'd
like to toast all of you. Really? I know that I'm the butt of your jokes, and that's just my cross to bear as the patriarch of our little family. Mark and Jamie, the two of you do the work of a team of 10. And Kate, despite our bickering, you are the heart of this show.
What the fuck is this?
Mark, what are you doing? Just stay back from it.
This is beyond messed up. I don't know what Charlie's gotten us into, but if I see Dumet, I'm gonna fuck him up.
Has anyone seen Mr. Dumet?
Jesus. It looks just like him. No way somebody just threw these together in the last couple of hours. Okay, this is fucked up. What the hell is going on?
You hear that?
Footsteps.
And they're getting closer.
Thank you.
Jamie! Thank God!
I'm so glad to see you guys. We have to get the hell out of here.
What happened when the wall closed?
Demet killed his groundskeeper.
What?
Right in front of us.
Demet?
It's a setup. He was wearing a mask, and I know how that sounds, but I'm not joking, and now he's after Aaron, so we need to move.
Wait, hang on. Where's Charlie?
I don't know. We got separated.
No way this is happening.
You know, so when our bodies wash up on the other side of the lake.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Bodies dead.
Jesus, shut it up!
Bodies dead. 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 Dead.
What was that?
This... it's fake. A prop, or from an animal or something. It has to be.
No, 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 no way.
Oh! Oh, it's real! It's fucking real! I told you, this was all too much! Let's get out of here. It's locked! What's going on? The door I came through is locked too.
Dumet! You wanna play around?
Get out here! Right now! Let's fucking play!
Shit. two. I'm assuming you've read my report on the first one? Similar MO, unidentified male with multiple stab wounds. Looking at the lower abdomen, the wounds are consistent with those of the first victim. The shape of the entry wound suggests it's a strong probability that this is the same murder weapon. Looks like we've got a souvenir hunter here. This time the left ear has been severed. Clean incision. Probably a scalpel or a razor blade. Very tidy. Nice job, actually. Very little bleeding. The deceased had probably been dead for 30 to 40 minutes when this was done. This differs from the earlier MO. If you remember, that John Doe was still alive when the teeth were removed. That would have created a lot of noise and mess. This guy is learning.
Trapped tonight. Well, if I get out, I'll send someone back for you.
For fuck's sake.
Thanks to Lord.
What's he doing?
Things are starting to heat up for our friends. Charlie's goose may be cooked. It can be difficult working with someone you've been involved with, but I think Mark and Kate may be finding a way and learning some new things about each other. And how do we feel about Mr. Dumet's lovely animatronics? I think they're rather clever. Some of them look very realistic. I wonder where he sources the parts. It would only be fair at this stage to offer up a little hint to even the odds. What do you think? Let's take some inspiration from the works of Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. Apparently, our friend Herman Mudgett was so enamored with Sherlock Holmes that he borrowed his surname. Here. He has a brain of the first order. He sits motionless like a spider in the center of its web. But that web has 1,000 radiations, and he knows well every quiver of each of them. I hope that helps. You'd better get back to things. Best of luck.
I could have saved him.
What if it's Aaron?
No way.
Damn it.
It's another trap.
It's the only way out of here. So we're going to find out.
Is this a good idea?
I don't see any other options.
Columbus Spa.
This is Laura at reception. The Columbus Spa is now open for guests. We treat each and every one of our guests like a real work of art.
Son of a bitch. He's watching us.
Look. Blood.
Shit, man.
Ah! Jesus!
Keep looking around.
In all visitors for the couple's treatments, please gather by the lobby doors in reception.
Worth a try.
I'll see if I can get this open. You guys keep looking for another way out.
Mark, give me a hand. I think we can bust through this thing.
Three, two, one, go! Go again. Ready? Three, two, one, go! Kate?
What happened?
We'll get back to you. Stay there.
Just hurry!
Oh, that hurt.
Script.
Stay close.
Obviously. What the fuck just happened? There must be something useful around here.
There's gotta be a way through.
Mark, give me a hand moving this shit. Mark, here. Let's move the desk. Hello? Mark? Jamie? Here.
Kate.
We're okay.
We're okay.
Thank God. We found a key. Let's get out of here. Thank you.
Hear that? This way.
Windows are welded in place. He fucking wants us to watch. Wait, look. Regulator switch.
Will that give them air?
No. Not both of them.
It's sucking out all the air.
Whoever we point this lever at is gonna die.
What?
Do something!
He wants to choose, doesn't he? Oh my God.
I can't.
If we don't do something, both of them will die, Mark.
Jamie, please.
I don't want to die.
I don't want to die. Please help me.
We have to choose. Now!
We had to do something! They were both gonna die!
Thank you! Thank you!
No, okay!
She's okay.
happening?
Dumet is playing a game, and it's no fucking joke.
You okay?
Just leave me alone.
Look, we have to get smart about this before one of us ends up dead like Charlie.
Wait, Charlie's dead?
Dumet got him and forced us to play some game. We had to watch him die.
We need a plan. Forget his games, traps, all that bullshit. Think about the killers we've covered. There's always a weakness.
You suggesting we invite him to tea and psychoanalyze?
I'm suggesting we use our heads.
We can make guesses all day, but if we die here, it won't matter. I'm not playing detective, I just want to survive.
Playing detective is how we survive. We play his games, we'll lose. We need to outthink him.
He's trying to pick us off one at a time. We need to stick together.
Hang on.
He could be listening to us right now.
Where should we go?
Back to the ferry.
It left, remember?
It's on a line. Maybe we could reel it in.
Maybe isn't good enough.
The lighthouse. Maybe we can signal for help. There's police boats patrolling the lakes, right?
All the way out here?
Lighthouses are meant to be seen for miles.
He's probably got it rigged with traps.
Then we gotta be really fucking careful. It's our best shot.
Are you shooting any of us? No one is gonna believe it without proof.
You want me to record him trying to kill us?
And the bodies? For the cops.
Hear that? The walls are moving again.
Kate, hang on. We need to stay close.
Shit! Kate! Hang on!
The mount matches. Perfect.
Thank you.
There we go.
Psychological assessment conducted by Dr. Isabella Garcia. Patient name, Monday, Hector. Behavioral observation. Hector arrived at our scheduled appointment 24 minutes late. Once we sat down and began the session, he struggled to maintain eye contact. He found it difficult to articulate his feelings and was terse and guarded throughout. Hector has been working long hours and, as a result, isn't sleeping well. Hector spoke about his recently deceased mother and displayed evidence that he hasn't yet fully come to terms with her death. I strongly recommended a course of antidepressants, but he is resistant to this idea, believing that it would have a detrimental effect on his capability with regards to his current investigation. Hector describes his work in immaculate detail, and contrary to earlier in the session, his thought content is both coherent and logical. He is displaying an unhealthy obsession with his work, but his recent bereavement may be the underlying issue.
Lab rat here for your amusement. So now what? we go. Are you fucking kidding me? What the hell? Oh, what the hell? Mark! Jesus, there's cameras.
I want to know what it means to be a killer. You ever been to the art museum downtown? They got this painting by a guy, I forget his name, famous painter. He did portraits of slaughtered cows hanging on hooks. You take a normal person to a slaughterhouse and they will puke their guts out. You make it into a painting and suddenly it's art. There's no difference between the two. Not really. Don't look at me like that. You know I'm right. You get it. I know you get it. You got to do something that matters. Make people feel something they've never felt before. Shatter the illusion that any of us are really in control. Think of the most profound thing you've ever done. The most beautiful thing you've ever created. And I promise you, it's nothing compared to watching the life bleed out of someone. To see the fear in their eyes. To feel them pawing at you for release. To hear them pleading, begging. That moment when someone realizes they are at their end. That's when you feel it. That's true art. That's what you have to be. An artist.